Hey guys, Spirit of the Law here. In this video, we're going to explore a pretty simple trick that has the potential to win you a lot of water battles that you'd otherwise probably lose. It all hinges on the Sicilians' team bonus, giving their transport ships plus 10 resistance to anti-ship bonus damage. So first of all, what exactly is that? Basically, it's damage that's independent from the melee or pierce attack shown in the unit's stats. Generally, units that are connected to water or have bonus damage against camels will have a bit of it. At the same time, different ships have varying amounts of resistance to this type of extra damage as well, with elite turtle ships and fire ships negating the most. Predicting naval matchups is actually fairly difficult given all of this is happening behind the scenes, and it's generally easier just to memorize which ones are good against others. Galleons, for example, do 11 bonus damage against other galleons, but only 2 bonus damage against fast fire ships, while fast fire ships do 4 extra damage against longboats and caravels, but no extra damage against turtle ships. You can see it's a lot to keep track of. An important case to note though for our purposes here is that the transport ship by default has no protection from anti-ship bonuses. Sicilian transport ships and their allies, however, gain plus 10 resistance, which you'll notice negates most if not all of the bonus damage from many units. So now that we have a sense of what's going on behind the scenes, the question I want to look at for this video is whether or not it's worth making transport ships as Sicilians or one of their allies for the sole purpose of tanking damage in naval fights, or whether you're better off not getting too fancy with it and just put those resources into making as many warships as possible. Starting off in Feudal Age, arguably this is a little early to use this trick, as water battles will typically be on a small scale, where players are going to focus fire and just ignore your transport ships. That said, let's run through a few tests anyway, just to see what happens. Now, a transport costs 125 resources compared to the galley and fire galley line's 120. The creation time is a bit shorter in Feudal Age, but to keep things relatively straightforward, I'm going to say that every time we make a transport ship in Feudal, it's at the cost of either a galley or fire galley. It doesn't work out exactly the same in all ways, but I don't think it's a difference worth getting hung up on. Starting with the galley, the simplest test is of course one galley and a Sicilian transport ship against two galleys, which again we're going to say is a balanced investment. Right away, you'll notice the transport ships run away when they take damage, which complicates the test. To do this properly, I either need to manually redirect the transport ship to stay in the fight or set waypoints for it to follow. That's admittedly an extra step, but it's not a difficult one. If we let it play out and the red galleys are stubborn enough to keep firing at the transport ship, you'll see the blue side actually wins. It's probably too early to call it, but this is a nice start and suggests that maybe Sicilian transport ships are worth using like this. Let's scale it up though to something a bit more reasonable and go with 8 galleys plus 2 transports against 10 galleys. In this case, you're more likely to see the red player patrol, which means their units will attack whatever is closest. It is quite a bit of micro to keep the transport ships engaged in the fight, but again we see as long as you're able to keep the enemy galley's attention, the transports are making up for blue's disadvantage in firepower. To put that in context, without the transport ships involved, red very easily snowballs the same fight, 10 versus 8, theoretically with at least half their HP left. The fact that two transport ships that don't even fire can turn that around is actually kind of impressive. I still think in a practical situation, the red player could wise up to what's going on and just focus fire down your galleys, and it wouldn't be until larger scale fights that focus firing would be impractical. Switching out to fire galleys, I found that the transport ships actually don't hold up very well here. It's a bit harder to get all the patrolled ships involved at once, and transports also take damage more quickly from fire ships in general. In fact, with equal resources, you appear to be better off just investing more into your own warships. Likewise, transports take the same number of hits from demo rafts as galleys, so again there's no obvious advantage to going with transports as a distraction unless there's something else going on, like you're trying to save on gold. Overall, in Feudal Age at least, it seems to have a bit of potential in large galley fights or against a player who doesn't micro, but that's about it. But let's switch to Castle Age now, where I'll assume we picked up Bodkin Arrow and Careening, though Careening affects pierce armor, so it shouldn't really matter here. Starting with war galleys, we'll do 15 against 13, but add in 2 extra transport ships. This is a scaled up fight, which seems reasonable given everyone's economies should be larger, and is a situation where a player could choose to simply patrol. Notice again, we have basically identical resources on each side at the beginning of the fight as well. Admittedly, it's a lot of work to keep the transport ships in the fight as they love to run away, but again, one or two transports more than justify their cost, as long as they're actually absorbing damage. The explanation is pretty simple. Each transport is taking 100 shots, which is about 8 times more than a war galley. Even if your opponent decides to focus fire or use shift to queue up targets, forcing them to do that instead of a simple patrol arguably has some value, and the bigger the fight, the more awkward it becomes to do those things. Once they have more than 13 or 15 ships, focus firing also starts to waste a lot of damage to overkill. Another point here is you don't need to control the transport ships for the entire fight. You just need to absorb enough damage that your navy has greater numbers, and then let Lanchester Square Law take it from there. In terms of the ideal number of transport ships for this trick, you do have some diminishing returns. You only need one or two to win a relatively close fight, and a general rule of one transport for every 10 to 15 enemy ships feels like the sweet spot. On the other hand, switching to fire ships, even in an ideal situation where you can get them to prioritize the transports, it turns out you're better off with just more of your own warships. The transports are just destroyed too quickly, and in fact, I would say fire ships are the easiest counter to Sicilian transports. Keep in mind, Castle Age also adds a couple of unique units to the mix. The caravel's damage is almost entirely negated by the extra armor, since most of its attack is actually coming from anti-ship damage. The longboat's attack also takes a pretty big hit, while the turtle ship is unaffected. Considering how common it is to see caravels and longboats on water maps, that's actually a pretty big deal. And finally, let's take a look at the Imperial Age. You might think we have the pattern figured out, but a couple of things change. First of all, notably with galleons specifically, Sicilian transport ships take 4 damage per attack as opposed to just 1 from the galley line in other ages. That's a combination of both the galleon's higher attack, but also an increase to their anti-ship bonus once you upgrade them to galleons specifically. Unfortunately, this is exactly the point in the game when fleets are getting large enough that players have to patrol rather than focus fire, and it turns out that's right when transport ships lose their ability to tank an insane number of shots. That said, with 25 galleons and 5 transport ships against 30 enemy patrolled galleons, I found that transport ships can consistently lead your navy to a small victory. I'd attribute this to the erratic behavior of the transports every time they're hit, as their constantly shifting movement throws off the enemy's ballistics and causes a lot of stray shots. It turns out there may still be a role for transport ships in large galleon fights, though if I take over for red and focus fire during the entire battle, it is still possible to win. Against fast fire ships, it's a fairly similar result to the galleon, in that they last just long enough to not look especially good or bad. Whenever I actually tried using transport ships against fire ships though, I found I couldn't draw the same amount of attention as I could from galleons, and I think it's another case where it's getting a bit too fancy, and you'd be better off with more warships. If you have the transport ships on hand, I think it's worth trying to get them involved, but I wouldn't create them specifically for that purpose. Now, demo ships are an interesting case, since Sicilian transports hold up worse than other warships, but demos are also 50 gold, while transports are 0. From a gold perspective, that's a great one-for-one trade, though keep in mind on water maps, wood can sometimes be more valuable than gold. On the other hand, against the unique water units, we see a similar result at Castle Age, where longboats and especially caravels are hurt by the Sicilian bonus, and turtle ships are unaffected. If you have a Sicilian player on your team and see either caravels or longboats being massed, it's at least worth recruiting any nearby transport ships to help as a damage sponge. In addition to all of these naval matchups though, remember that many units also have some relevant bonuses here. For example, pikemen, eagles, camels, ballista elephants, and watchtowers all do up to 10 less damage. Transport ships obviously aren't a counter to any of these or anything like that, but on hybrid maps you're much less likely to get sniped by some of these units when trying to land. I see that more as a secondary benefit of the bonus in the odd situation. If anything, it also emphasizes how silly some of the usual counters to transport ship landings are, and how the combined legacy armor class of camels and ships can still show up and have an impact on the game today. The bonus is also great against defensive buildings with heated shot, and notably castles can no longer do over 100 damage in a single volley. A small note here as well is that Saracens benefit in particular, since after all this is a team bonus, which stacks with the Saracens' double HP for their transports. Combined with their faster attack and galley line, they arguably stand to benefit the most from this bonus. Now before wrapping up, I got curious about whether this strategy is ever actually used by players online. I can't be the only one who's thought of this, so I spectated some ranked team games being played on islands where someone had chosen Sicilians, to get a sense of whether or not anyone is actually using transports in this way, and I did see a couple of notable examples. In this example here, Mr. Sam is orange, has a Sicilian ally, and is very obviously trying to use his transports to distract enemy units. You can see he brings them in to intentionally draw the fire ship's attention. Unfortunately, as we've seen, fire ships are actually fairly strong against transports, but what's interesting is how well the transport ship running away mechanic works to his advantage. You can see a handful of fire ships get distracted by a transport and harmlessly float past the rest of Orange's navy. They take a lot of extra damage from Orange's fire ships and end up being pretty much ineffective in this fight, thanks to one hero transport. Unfortunately, there was a bit of fighting under a castle at the end, but in this case, it was remarkably effective. Jumping back to the start of the fight, Green had an apparent advantage in fireship numbers, but ended up taking a lot of free hits and losing the engagement, which was arguably thanks in large part to the creative use of his transports. The same player, in fact, attempted to use the trick a few other times, but the first one was the most impressive demonstration. A As another example, here we have 6 war galleys in a different game being given up essentially for free because of 2 Sicilian transports. Don't mind the failed castle and landing attempt, but instead notice the idle transport ships distracting the war galleys, saving a fair amount of HP on a nearby group of longboats. This was definitely an unintended use of the bonus, but you can see how easy it is to distract enemy units. On the whole though, most players I notice don't use the trick, even in situations where it seems like it would have been perfect. In fact, I often saw players with the Sicilian bonus run away with their transport ships before a fight where they would have been a big asset. Overall, I'd say the trick feels underutilized in the 15 or so games I watched, but in a way that's understandable, as using transport ships in this way is a bit counterintuitive. It doesn't help that Sicilians are a relatively new civilization as well, and I suspect a lot of players are thinking more about their own civ than their allies' team bonuses. I think the takeaway is there's some potential here in the right situation for this trick to help, whether that be against mass galleons, caravels, longboats, or maybe even fireships, as we saw. That's all for this one though. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you next time.